Today we're going to be talking about Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter by Seth Grahame-Smith. This is going to be the shortest summary in the world because the title of this book is pretty self-explanatory. Abraham Lincoln fights some motherfucking vampires. So I picked this book up because the movie is coming out soon, and I don't know if you've seen the trailer for it, but it looks so cool. And I kind of think that this might end up being the rare occasion where the movie is better than the book, because I did not think this book was very good at all. Okay, see, with a book like this, you kind of expect it to be dumb, but you also expect it to be, you know, really fun. And, this got one of those down. It's presented as a nonfiction text, which I originally thought was a really interesting idea, but it eventually just gets really dry. And if I say something is dry, it's really dry. I have a very high tolerance for dryness. I think it just takes itself way too seriously and it's played way too straight. I also don't think that Seth Grahame-Smith's strength as a writer is writing action, which is sort of the point of this. Also, it just did a couple of things that I personally find really annoying. Like, okay, dream sequences. We need to talk about dream sequences. It's not like I hate all dream sequences. I think they can be used very effectively, but these dream sequences are the really annoying kind where they're presented just as straight text, and then at the end it's like, oh, JK, Abraham Lincoln woke up and, ugh. And if it had done this once, that would have been fine, but it kept happening. And the dream sequences were always about people close to him dying, and so, you know, halfway through one, you'd be like, oh, Mary Todd Lincoln just died, so this is clearly a dream sequence. Oh, I hate that so much. Also, the ending is stupid. Obviously, I'm not going to tell you what happens to keep this spoiler-free, but it is, like, my least favorite ending trope, probably. So this is a semi-historic moment in the history of mother-effing books, because this is the first time I'm just going to give a blanket, don't read this, to a book. Because even when I give negative reviews, I always try to state what kind of person I think would like this book, but I just can't in good conscience recommend this to anybody. And it's not like it's terrible. If it were terrible, it would probably be entertaining in its incompetency. It's just mediocre and dull. Like, it's not trying to say anything, and it's also not like a dumb good time, so I just kind of don't think you should bother. Oh my god, the more I talk about this book, the madder I get, and I don't know why, because it's not worth it. Okay, if you have also read this book, I would love to know what you thought, because I mean, this sold a ton of copies, so somebody liked it, and I will see you soon. Bye.